श्री भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी शिल प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासि गौर भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपी गो श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जय। समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री गुरु गौरांग की जय। ओम नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी विकास स्वामी के नाम नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी के नाम नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। वंदेहम श्री गुरु श्री उत्पदकमलम श्री गुरु वैष्णवांश श्री रूपम साग्र जातम सहग्न रघुनाथान्वितम तम सजीवम साद्वैतम सावधूतम परिजन सहितम कृष्ण चैतन्य देवम श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहग्न ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। यस्टरडे वी वर डिस्कसिंग दैट सम आर कमेंट्स दैट some more comments on that Brajarasa Bhavana and that verse which I quoted from Prabodhananda Saraswati Chaitanya Chandramrita. That song is also there, no? Similar in similar lines by Vasu Ghosh. Yadi gaur na hoi to tabe ki hoi to kimono dhari tande राधार महिमा प्रेम रस सीमा लाइक दैट यू नो इन दैट। सो एनीवे नाउ दैट छल भक्ति दूषण द सेकेंड लास्ट वन आफ्टर दिस छल भक्ति दूषण देर इज ओनली वन नेम राम इज देयर। सो छल भक्ति Chala Bhakti means what? Chala Bhakti Dushana. Dushana means again destroying. So Chala Bhakti means pretentious, hypocritical Bhakti. In Bhagavad Gita, third chapter, it comes, no? That मिथ्याचारस उच्यते दैट वर्ड कम्स मिथ्याचारी इन द पाथ ऑफ योगा प्रिटेंडर। सो प्रिटेंडर इज डिफाइंड देयर मिथ्याचारस उच्यते। देर आर मेनी वर्ड्स विच आर डिफाइंड इन भगवद्गीता लाइक दैट हु इज अ मिथ्याचारी। सो लाइक दैट देर आर मेनी वर्ड्स उच्यते उच्यते कम्स यू नो डिफरेंट प्लेसेस एंड सम अदर फ्यू वर्ड्स कम लाइक दैट। So there are definitions. So you can make a Bhagavad Gita dictionary, Sanskrit dictionary actually, based on Bhagavad Gita. Just like so they are just like Amar Simha wrote that Amarakosha, Yaska Muni wrote Nirukta. Similarly, you can make a Bhagavad Gita dictionary. Someone must have done also already. So these definitions are there. So Indriyani Charatini, what is that? Indriya. Yeah. Anyway, the point is that so he has given up, externally he has given up objects of sense gratification, but still he harbors attachment to them. So such person is, and mind is focused on that still. He is a mithyachari, he says. So here pretentious and hypocritical devotion, chala bhakti doshana. And yesterday we mentioned that, Mahaprabhu's mercy was not unconditional. I gave some examples. I gave example of Jagai Madai. He put some condition there. So like that. Yesterday's what was example in connection with that, why that point came? I don't remember now. Kala Krishna Das and Chota Hari Das, yes. He was not all merciful, Chaitanya. Of course, he is all merciful. But the way we define him as, you know, and at least in modern ISKCON. So, he is defined as unconditional, all merciful. You can do anything with him. You can do anything with his deities, Gaur Nithai. You don't have to follow any rules to worship Gaur Nithai deities. So these are all bogus ideas. So and especially deity worship, we have to be very careful actually. One argument comes regarding worshipping deities, Gaur Nithai deities. Prabhupada told them to make Gaur Nithai dolls and distribute them widely like that. He said they bring that. Sell them, he said. So, if non-devotees purchase Gaur Nithai dolls, they may not follow rules and regulations. They may even eat meat also. That's okay. But if the devotee has Gaur Nithai deities, but if he doesn't follow rules and regulations, that is not okay. You understood the difference between both of them? So Mahaprabhu will be merciful to non-devotees, but he will not be merciful to devotees. So these things have to be properly understood, yeah. I mean to say, after becoming devotee, you have to become serious. You can't be like non-devotee. Then there will be no difference between devotee and non-devotee. Then there is no meaning to be a devotee, right? So, and even dolls, after distributing, what we are going to do? We have to go and do Sankirtana, definitely, right? Devotees have to go and do Sankirtana in their home, no? So then they will be pleased, right? Those.
Lord Chaitanya is the soul, yeah. So point is, he destroys pretentious and hypocritical devotion. So this has to be, So Chota Haridas and Kala Krishna Das, it happened. There are many examples for this, and there is a lot to discuss on this point, Chala Bhakti Dushana. Ramdas Vishwas is one example. He was a Ram, the name says, he was a Ramadasa. He was a devotee of Lord Rama. He would chant 24 hours a day the name of Lord Rama. Always chant Ram, Ram, Ram. So he came to Jagannath Puri with Gopala Bhatta Goswami from Varanasi, obviously, because Gopala Bhatta Goswami was in Varanasi. His father was Tapan Mishra. So when he came to Jagannath Puri, along with him, Ramdas Vishwas also came. And so because... What I said?
Gopal.
Sorry, Gopal. Not Gopal, but it is Raghunath Bhatta, sorry. So, sometime it happens, no? In the mind it is, and it comes in the world something else. So, Gopal Bhatta, anyway, he was a Brahmin, from Brahmin caste. And Ramadas Vishwas was a Kayastha. So, those days in Bengal, Kayastha means Shudras. There are only two castes in those days, Brahmin and Shudra, that's all. And Kayasthas would do all the, even administration also. So Brahmin, so Ramdas Vishwas, he said, oh, I am your servant. So he even carried the luggage of Raghunath Bhatta Goswami on the way to Jagannath Puri. So much humble attitude. But when he came to Jagannath Puri and met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would not accept him, because Ramdas Vishwas had, along with bhakti, he had what? Impersonal idea. He had desire to merge with Lord Ram or whatever, become one with Lord Ram. So in this way, he did not accept him. So someone may chant the holy names, but if our, like you see now, chanting holy name is also so much overstressed. Sometimes to the extent that you can be a Mayavadi, you may have a Mayavadi attitudes, but you can just go on chanting Hare Krishna. Of course, chanting Hare Krishna purifies, but association with pure devotees, learning philosophy properly, it's also important. Rupa Goswami, he discussed relation between bhakti and jnana. So until we establish our footing in bhakti, we should cultivate knowledge, he says. And Jiva Goswami, in his commentary on Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, he explains that, giving example of tattva masi, you know, there is three things in this tattva masi. Tat padartha, tvam padartha, tattva masi. These three are there. Tat padartha means that is Supreme Absolute Truth or Krishna. Vadanti tat tattva vidas tat is called, right? That. Then tvam means you, right? So, Lord is there and you are there. And that the third one, what is called as, it means it is interpretation. Actually, it is not the real meaning of tattvamasi, tattvam. You are that. So, a Mayavadi guru teaches his disciple, when he, guru disciple asks, who am I? Then Mayavadi guru teaches that I am that. You are that, sorry. So, of course, I am that also. So he teaches him, you are that. So tattvamasi. We reject that part, he says, that portion. Jiva Goswami, third one, you are that portion. Actually, you are that means, it is true meaning of that tattvamasi, but you are that means applies to Supreme Lord. When we have to go in front of the deity form of the Lord, or different avatars, when Lord descends to this world, then we pray to the Lord that you are that same Supreme Absolute Truth. That is the meaning of it. It's a prayer actually. Tattvamasi is a prayer to Krishna's avatars and Krishna's deity form actually. You are not stone. You are that same Supreme Absolute Truth. Murti nahi tumi Vrajendra Nandana in Chaitanya Charitamrita it comes. So that is the purport of Tattvamasi actually. Pratima nahi tumi Vrajendra Nandana. So like that. So in this way, so we should know philosophy also. We should know. Sometime even Prabhupada said to the extent that let them not to be initiated. Not to be initiated means they may not even chant 16 rounds actually. Let them understand our philosophy, that's all he says. So the point is, and there are so many academic scholars who were very favorable to ISKCON and Prabhupada's teachings, who did service to, sometimes they did service to Srila Prabhupada. They didn't chant Hare Krishna, they didn't take initiation, but still they are devotees. devotees means are at least whatever service they did, it should be accepted as devotional service. Like there was one, I think it is Thomas O'Connell or one of them. So he, somebody made objection about proper translation of the first verse of Bhagavad Gita. Dharma Kshetre, Kuru Kshetre, another academic scholars. And this person, he smashed him left, right, bottom. That fellow must have passed two levels. Like that. So many times they have done some intellectual level service, you know, and service on the level of intelligence. So therefore, understanding philosophy is also very important. So Ramachandra Vishwas is one example. You can take even example of Ramachandra Puri. His bhakti also was, he took initiation from Madhavendra Puri, but he became a Mayavadi later. That is like Vaishnava Aparad and a critical mentality. So then there is example from that Brahmana from Bengal who wrote a Sanskrit drama and wanted to present in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He wanted to read in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Like eventually you all learn Sanskrit and write dramas and poetry. We have to be careful. Philosophically it should be in line. So, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had a system. I think it was a common affair in those days. Such people would come to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So he had made this rule that first everyone should pass through Swarup Damodar Goswami before they come to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And we all know Swarup Damodar Goswami. Why Swarup Damodar Goswami? Like other day we discussed about Rupa Goswami. So Swarup Damodar Goswami also was, he also understood the inner heart's desire of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Chaitanya Manobhishta. So this incident exemplifies that. So Ramdas, this Brahmana from Bengal, he came, he wanted to read. Then actually he didn't directly approach Swarup Damodar. He came with another friend, I think Jagadananda Pandit or one of them. So he brought him to meet. Then when Swarup Damodar Goswami heard that, he became upset and first he chastised that friend of that Brahmana who brought him, who was also associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then you are also like coward boy and you have brought another coward boy from Vrindavan. Then basically the mistake that fellow had made is that Brahmana had made is that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Jagannath himself, which is true, but he had made him Chaitanya Mahaprabhu more than Jagannath. You are actually living conscious Jagannath, but that the deity in the temple is wooden Jagannath, like that, you know. He made Lord Jagannath as just an wood, actually. It's just a wood. So in this way there was a Mayavad contamination there. So Swarup Damodar Goswami heavily chastised him and sent him away. So like that, many people who would come to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So the point is that whoever brought that Brahmana, he also did not understand Siddhanta properly. That means there were many associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu who didn't know Siddhanta properly. pure bhakti. So it seems that they had contamination. That is one example. So this is all chala bhakti. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur wrote two songs. No, he wrote many songs, maybe. So those two songs, one is Vaishnavke and another one is Prakrita Rasa Shata Dushani. Vaishnavke is Babaji. No, before I go to this point, Vaishnavke. So we will discuss about the whole Sahajiya groups, you know. Sahajiya Bhakti is also Chala Bhakti, it is. It is a pretentious, hypocritical bhakti, it is. So, Sahajiyaism. So, we have to be very careful. We are, I don't think so in modern ISKCON, there is so much really zeal for understanding Siddhanta, understanding proper path of bhakti, actually. So, it's like just chant Hare Krishna. Of course, four regulative principles is discussed till now. When it will close down, we don't know. Why? Because nowadays, gradually, homosexuality is becoming acceptable in ISKCON. Sannyasi is doing blessing homosexual gay marriages. At least I saw some 2-3 instances of such. So it seems that gradually we are forgetting four regulative principles. So there is no zeal, at least, for understanding the proper path of bhakti. So the point is then that we become sahajiyas. So Prabhupada, he defined sahajiya in Chaitanya Charitamrita purport. Any kind of deviation is called as sahajiya, he says. That is definition of sahajiya. So, of course, when we speak about sahajiya, we are speaking about prakrita sahajiyas. Prakrita sahajiyas means they are mundane. Why Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur used this term prakrita sahajiya? Because sahajiya word can also apply to pure devotees, actually. Because bhakti is natural. Sahajiya means what? Natural. One meaning of sahajiya. So natural, bhakti is natural. And for pure devotees, bhakti is natural. Spontaneous it is. So spontaneous devotion can also be called as sahajiya. So here when we make prakrita sahajiyas are those mundane devotees. They are prakrita devotees. They are, we can, in English, prakrita Prabhupada, prakrita bhakta, he translated them as neophytes. So they take bhakti as cheap, actually, basically. Take it for granted that they are already pure devotees, although they may harbor lots of anarthas. And they may take higher levels of bhakti as granted. Now already I have achieved without passing through the lower levels. Anartha, especially anartha nivritti, they think that we are already pure devotees. So this is sahajiyaism. And many sahajiya groups, they started even when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was present. So another point to understand is that there are deviations in. So any deviation means what? So there are so many deviant groups, paramparas and sampradayas since from the beginning of creation. Like Mayavadi is one sahajiya. So it's a one deviant group, it is, basically. They accept Vedic authority.
I can't help you with that at the moment.
So they accept Vedic authority, they study Vedanta, but their understanding of Vedanta, interpretation of Vedanta is deviant, it is. So we can call that is also apasampradaya. So apasampradayas. Yeah, this point of apasampradaya. So there are unlimited number of apasampradayas. So sahajiyas are also apasampradayas. So any kind of deviations from true Vedic path, they are all apasampradayas. Like Buddha Jain also could be told as apasampradayas of Vedic, you know, Vedic apasampradayas. So, like here, there is Basavanna cult is there, Lingayat cult is there. It's also apasampradaya, Vedic apasampradaya. Then, of course, they don't accept Vedic authority. They are fully atheistic. Then there is this Shaivism, Shaiva Sampradaya from South India. There is Shaktas, North India and Bengal, worshippers of Shakti. So all these are Apa Sampradayas. But within Mahaprabhu's movement in Gaudiya Sampradaya, so many hundreds of Apa Sampradayas they came, originated. And many of them they started even while Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was present. This Ativadi Apa Sampradaya. Ativadi is like Apa Brahmsha, Ati Bhari, Bhari, Bhari in Bengali, Ati Bhari. So Ativadi Apa Sampradaya is there. Ati Bhari means what? Too great. Too great. So that was started by one person called Jagannath Das. He actually wrote a Oriya. He is from Orissa. He wrote a Bhagavatam in Oriya actually. I think it has little differences from original Bhagavatams. So he wanted to read that, I think, in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, you are too great, I am very insignificant, like that. Then the followers of this Jagannath Das made him greater than Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, our guru is, our leader is greater than Chaitanya. That's how Ativadi Apa Sampradaya came. So, sometime it appears that these are all psychological syndromes actually, all these Apa Sampradayas. So, sometime one would be, you see this narcissistic syndrome, it is in psychology. And mental health, they discuss this narcissistic syndrome means someone is always immersed in, absorbed in one's own greatness actually. That is what is Ativadi. Actually that narcissistic syndrome came from one fellow whose name was Narcissist, French fellow. Whole life he was absorbed in just looking at his own picture actually. He was so much absorbed and enamored by his own form whole life. So from there that syndrome was, that name was coined actually. So this is Ativadi Apa Sampradaya. Seems like all these are all some psychological, of course that is modern psychological interpretation, but we can call them as anarthas. So egocentric, that is Ativadi Apa Sampradaya. So then so like that many groups came, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he summarized some of them. Actually, he took it from one. He wrote. It seems that there are articles in Sajjana Toshani. He described these Apa Sampradaya groups. So, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur was very strong in writing, and he exposed all these wrong groups, deviant groups, and there is a translation, or it is actually his own book. Our Suvatra Swami wrote 13 Apa Sampradayas, and in that, so he speaks about these 13 Apa Sampradaya groups, but there are hundreds of Apa Sampradayas. Mm. So, but it seems to me that Bhaktivinoda Thakur has not just, because in that book, Swatra Maharaj, he says that Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he wrote about 13 apasam. He definitely, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written about many apasampradayas. Even this Babaji, in general, that Babaji apasampradaya, they may come in many groups actually. One individual may come in Babaji apasampradaya, he may come in Athibadi also, and he may come in Gaura Nagari, like that, Aula, Baula, like that there are. So they may come in many actually. So this Babaji apasampradaya, there is one article by Bhaktivinoda Thakur called Perils of Babaji Life. So very systematically he presents that how different kinds of, four kinds of renunciation, and how pretentious renunciation this Babaji life is. So he exposes them. And generally Babaji's, they used to do Nirjan Bhajan. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur wrote that song, no? Vaishnava K. That was particularly focused on this Babaji apasampradaya actually. Who were externally showing, making show of doing Nirjan Bhajan. There is no wrong in Nirjan Bhajan actually. Many of our acharyas also, they did that. Gaur Kishordas Babaji Maharaj, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur also in that, towards the end he retired from even. So he took Babaji Vesh and he was busy in, he was absorbed in Nirjan Bhajan. So in this way, they were engaged in, so Nirjan Bhajan, there is no wrong in that. In fourth canto of Bhagavatam, Prabhupada, he mentioned in that Puranjana section, Prabhupada mentioned that eventually the disciple should take preaching responsibility and help the spiritual master to retire and do Nirjan Bhajan actually, Prabhupada said that. And of course writing books, Prabhupada had desire to write books often he had expressed that. So then like this there are this Babaji, Nirjan Bhajan is there, but along with that, these Babajis, what they will do? They will not. They will just make show of Nirjan Bhajan. Gaur Kishordas Babaji Maharaj, he mentioned about one of his imitator follower, that he gave an example of making sound like a pregnant woman of labor pain, you know. Due to labor pain, pregnant women, they make sound, you know. In the labor room doesn't give the result of child actually. Imitating that labor pain will not give result of child. Childbirth will not happen there. Similarly, by imitating Nirjan Bhajan, so it will not happen. So like that, so Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur severely criticized. Dushtamana Thumi Kisera Vaishnav. Basically he is telling you Dushta Babajis, what kind of devotees you are, like that. You see, allegorically, right? It is, he is blaming his own mind actually, what kind of Vaishnav you are. But it is actually what? So indicating to this Babaji apasampradaya actually. Wicked mind, what kind of Vaishnava are you? Your show of chanting Harinam is in a solitary place is for false prestige, simply hypocrisy. Kevala Kaitava. This is Kaitava Bhakti or Chala Bhakti it is. So now another point before I start, we discuss this. More than any other acharya, just these recent acharyas, especially Bhaktisiddhanta, Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, because they have, these two acharyas have heavily, their whole preaching was concentrated and attacking these upper sampradayas actually. This chala bhakti basically. Because already they were devotees, they were chanting Hare Krishna. But their bhakti was pretentious and hypocritical. Prabhupada didn't have to, he has written, of course he has incorporated lot of those things, refutation of these upper sampradayas from Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur in his own books. Mostly they are incorporated from Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, because Prabhupada had to, he was not just dealing with Bengali and Odisha, you know, Bengali society actually. So Prabhupada had a larger issues, global issues actually. Prabhupada was defeating science, Prabhupada was, you know, especially social issues, he dealt with a lot, you know, to a large extent, more than any other acharya. He dealt with the socio-political issues of the world, how we can give a better Krishna conscious alternative to the society in the form of Varnashrama society, centered around Daiva Varnashrama, centered around Krishna. So he had a global issues. And Western philosophy, Prabhupada discussed, you know, about Western philosophers and their. So he was dealing with global issues. But particularly Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and more than Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote about them in his books. And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, literally day and night, he was just focused on attacking these upper sampradayas. Therefore, this song, you know, is one such hypocritical, pretentious bhakti. So basically they were not actually real Babajis, they were making show off. Jadera pratishta stukera ravishta janana kitaha mayara vaibhav khanaka kamini divasa yamini bhaviya kika janitya is. So mundane prestige is like hog's tool. Do you not know that such refute is an illusion cast by Maya? What is the value of contemplating wealth, woman, day and night? All that is temporary. So seems like in those days, Babajis were respected very much in Bengali society, and definitely in Vrindavan area also. Because a lot of Bengalis had migrated there. So Gaudiya Vaishnavism means mostly it was Bengalis. So they were heavily respected. And just to earn that respect, so they were taking Babaji Vesh, but they were all absorbed in Kanaka and Kamini. Tomara Kanaka Bogera Janaka Kanakera Dware Seho Madhav Kamini Rekama Nahe Tabadama Tahara Malika Kevalakaita. It's very simple Bengali, you can understand. Tomara Kanaka Bogera Janaka Pratishtashataru Jada Maya Maru Na Pele Ravana Yujiya Ragava. So Ravana fought with Lord Ramchandra to gain tree of worldly reputation. Yet that apparent oasis was merely a mirage in the desert of Lord's material potency. So allegorically explaining, because wealth is Sita. Sita Devi is wealth, no? Lakshmi Devi, she is. So be attached to the solid position of a Vaishnava. Vaishnava pratishta tate koronishta tahana bajile labi rau rau. So if you neglect worshipping Krishna, he will go to hell. So harijana dvesha pratishta shaklesha karakena thabe tahara gaurav. Why do you envy Vaishnavas and suffer torment by desires of the honor accorded by them? So if you want name, fame, position, then what will happen? You will envy pure Vaishnavas. Vaishnavas have left behind desires for worldly fame. The fame that automatically follows them is never a temporary worldly opulence. So he is saying that pratishta will automatically come. And that pratishtha which is earned by pure devotees is not worldly pratishtha, it is. So you can see that now devotees like Prahlad are glorified, right? Till today, Prahlad, Parikshit, their bhakti, Narad Muni. Se hari sambandha shunya maya ganda thaha kabu na jadera kaitav. The fame comes from a devotee's relationship with Lord Hari. It is devoid of even a trace of worldly illusion and is untinged by materialistic cheating propensity. So, pratishta chandali nirjana tha jali ubaye jani ho mai karavro. The prestige of so-called popularity within the material realm is compared to a female dog eater, chandali. We can call it as a witch also. Attempting to live in solitude to supposedly perform bhajana is compared to an entangling network. Know that anyone striving in either of these ways lives in the hell of illusion. These vendors, they make really loud sound. In train also, they will not allow you to sleep morning. They will start early morning. Chai chai, late night, chai chai. So, So what is that? Pratishtha nirjanata jhali. Attempting to live in solitude to supposedly perform bhajana is compared to an entangling network. Know that anyone striving in either of these ways lives in the hell of illusion. Kirtana chadiba pratishtha makiba kikaja dudiya tadrasha gaurav. I shall give up kirtana and smear myself with worldly honor. What is the good of seeking that kind of glory? So kirtana chadiba here, especially preaching actually. So basically Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur suggested to take sannyas than taking Babaji Vesh actually. So that means preaching is a purificatory process which is given by our acharyas actually. Means if you are in preaching field, tendency to purify oneself is more than being a Babaji actually. Because you will try, you strive to come up to the standards actually. What is good of seeking that kind of glory? Of course, we have to follow at least basic four regulative principles. And there are many more standards actually. So, I will always remind you that Madhavendra Puri never deceived himself by stealing from the storehouse of emotion. Na karila kabu sadai janaba. Madhavendra Puri's example he is giving. Tomara pratishta shukarera nivishta thara sahasama. Why Madhavendra Puri? Because he is original tree actually. Original root of the tree of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. Tomara pratishta shukarera nivishta thara sahasama kabu na manav. Your cheap reputation is hog's tool and should never be equated with honor accorded to eminent devotees like Madhavendra Puri. Tarasama. Matsarata vashe. So, what happened with Madhavendra Puri? If you see that Gopinath stole that kheer for Madhavendra Puri and Madhavendra Puri didn't want that prestige to be, you know, published. I mean, published in the sense, publicized. No. So, but that although he didn't have desire to publicize that, before he reached Jagannath Puri, already his glories had reached there. Actually, that Gopinath had stolen. So this pratishtha don't compare with your pratishtha, he says here to Babaji's. Under the sway of envy, after having abandoned the excellence of congregational kirtana, you have absorbed yourself in material rasa. Oh yeah, another point here I made, that kirtana means preaching here. See, Babaji's, they also don't do congregational chanting actually, congregational kirtana. So which is our main process, right? Anyway, they say we are engaged in smarana. We are above kirtana and shravana. Kirtana and shravana are, shravana and kirtana are for neophytes. We are very advanced, they think actually. Under the sway of envy, after having abandoned the excellence, here we understand the importance of sankirtan actually. So sometimes these tendencies may be seen. We want to avoid attending kirtan and do some nirjan bhajan, in the corner of the ashram. So we have to be careful with that. Whenever there is opportunity to attend kirtan, kindly attend kirtan. Under the sway of envy, after having abandoned the excellence of congregational, you have absorbed yourself in material rasa. Tumi jada rase. Thai dustamana nirjana bhajana. Prachari cha chale kuyogi vaibhava. Prabhu sanatane paramayatane shikshadilayaha. Chinta sei sava. Therefore, O wicked mind, the glories of self-styled solitary worship are propagated only by false yogis using unscrupulous means to deceive others. To save yourself from these pitfalls, please carefully contemplate the instructions given by Lord Chaitanya to Sanatana Goswami. Shiksha dilayaha chinta sei sabha. So he explained all the sadhana bhakti, angas of sadhana bhakti to Sanatana Goswami. Sei dushtakata. Yes, sei duti kata bulana. Here that false yogi, it is kuyogi vaibhava. Here kuyogi means it is actually pretentious, this chala bhakta. Pretentious, false devotee devoid of character, Bhaktivinoda Thakura describes that. Sei dhuti kata bulana sarvata uchaswara khara hari nama rava palgu ara yukta bhadda ara mukta kabuna bhaviba ekha kara sabha. Palgu vairagya, yukta vairagya, bhadda and mukta, don't misunderstand them. And chant the holy names loudly, means sankirtan, take part in sankirtan like that. Kanak kamini pratishta bhogini chadi ache yare seita vaishnava. We are just going fast actually, we can't, because it's a lot. So who gives up this Kanaka Kamini Pratishta Bhagini? He is actually real Vaishnava. Sei anasakta shei suddha bhakta samsara taha paya parabhava. So such devotee who gives up all this Kanaka Kamini Pratishta Bhagini. Regarding Kanaka Kamini, actually, Bhakti Srila Prabhupada, in first canto of Bhagavatam, he writes, these are the most dangerous things for a devotee. And he says that many, in recent history, many stalwart devotees are deviated from the path going back home, back to Godhead, because of these two things, he says, in recent history. So we can say it again also. In recent history, again, many stalwart devotees have deviated. Although Chandrapa will tell a lot of stories. Broadcasting. Of course, you don't. Sorry. Yata yogya bhoga nahi tata roga anasakta sei ki arakahaba asakti rahita sambandha sahita vishaya samuha sakali madhav. So this yukta vairagya hid. One who partakes moderately of worldly things deemed necessary for performing bhajana is indeed detached and does not succumb to disease of material infatuation. So sometimes we misunderstand yukta vairagya. So that is another issue in modern ISKCON actually. Yukta Vairagya. Everyone does anything and everything in the name of Yukta Vairagya. So Yukta Vairagya is not meant for grahasthas actually. It is meant for only preachers, selected preachers actually. Of course, to some extent one may do. Yatha, that is what is yatharam, according to one's quality. Anasaktasya vishayan yatharam upayunjata, according to one's qualification. One should engage in Yukta Vairagya. Not Yukta Vairagya is also not unconditional. You cannot just go on. Then you become like karmi actually, sense enjoyer. So one who partakes moderately of worldly things deemed necessary for performing bhajana is indeed detached and does not succumb to the disease of material infatuation. Devoid of selfish attachment and accepting everything in relation to the Lord, he perceives all sense objects as non-different from Madhava. Se yukta vairagya taha ta saubhagya taha hi jadete harira vaivav kirtane jahara pratishta sambhara. So Tahara Sampatti Kevala Kaitav. So such a devotee is very fortunate who really understood what is Yukta Vairagya, or who is engaged in proper Yukta Vairagya. The attainment of one who chants Lord's names hoping to enhance his own material prestige is simply hypocrisy. Kaitav again. Vishaya Mumukshu Bhogera Bhubukshu Dhuye Theja Mana Dhuyi Avaishnav. O mind, reject those seeking impersonal liberation and those desiring sense objects. Both are non-devotees. Things used in relation to Krishna belong to the transcendental realm. They are never material products. And thus can neither be owned by persons interested in mundane enjoyment nor forsaken by persons seeking renunciation of material objects. मायावादी जन कृष्णेतर मन मुक्त अभिमाने से निंदे वैष्णव वैष्णवेर दास तव भक्ति आशा केनव ढाकी च निर्जन आहव. द माइंड ऑफ अ मायावादी इज इन्वॉल्व्ड इन मैटर्स अदर देन कृष्ण. कंसीडरिंग हिमसेल्फ लिबरेटेड ही क्रिटिसाइजेस वैष्णव. ओ माइंड, बीइंग अ सर्वेंट ऑफ द वैष्णवाज, यू शुड ऑलवेज होप टू अटेन डिवोशन. व्हाई डू यू इंस्टेड मेक सच पेंडिमोनियम अबाउट युवर सॉलिटरी वर्शिप. ये फलगु वैरागी कहे निज त्यागी सेना फरे खबु हई ते वैष्णव. हरिपाद छाड़ी निर्जन तभाड़ी लभिया की फल फलगु से वैभव. वन हु आर्टिफिशियली शंस व्हाट कुड बी यूज्ड इन क्रिस्ट लॉर्ड सर्विस कॉलिंग हिमसेल्फ अ रिनाउंसिएट कैन नेवर बिकम अ वैष्णव. बाय अबैंडनिंग हरिज लोटस फीट एंड रिमेनिंग इन अ कॉटेज ऑफ सॉलिट्यूड व्हाट विल ही गेन बिसाइड्स एन इनसब्सटेंशियल ग्लोरी. राधा दास से रही छाड़ी भोग आही प्रतिष्ठा से नाही कीर्तन गौरव. राधा नित्य जन थाहा छाड़ी मन खेवा खेनवा निर्जन भजन कैतव. रिमेन इन राधा सर्विस एंड रिजेक्ट द स्नेक ऑफ मटेरियल एंजॉयमेंट. द ग्लोरी ऑफ कीर्तन इज नॉट फॉर अटेनिंग पर्सनल रिकग्निशन. ओ माइंड, व्हाई हैव यू अबैंडन यूर आइडेंटिटी एज राधाज एटर्नल सर्वेंट्स टू प्रैक्टिस द चीटिंग निर्जन भजन. ओके, अनदर लास्ट टू. व्रजवासी गण प्रचारक धन प्रतिष्ठा शिक्षु का तारा नहीं शव प्राणाचे तंड्र से हेतु प्रचार प्रतिष्ठा शही न था कृष्ण गात सब. एक्चुअली दिस 18th इट इंडिकेट्स द मिशन ऑफ श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर. बिकॉज इन द नेम ऑफ ब्रज भक्ति ब्रजवासीज आर द वेल्थ ऑफ द प्रीचर्स. They never aspire for material reputation cherished only by the living dead. This has a lot of meaning actually. Vrajavasi gana pracharaka dana. So it's a deep, very deep it is. Means generally in Gaudiya Sampradaya it is, we are supposed to follow these Vrajavasis, but they are not actually impressed by this Babaji life. So they are actually wealth of preachers actually. So Vrajavasis, they appreciate Vrajavasis means not this modern Vrindavan vasis actually. Here we are talking about eternal associates of the Lord actually. Vrajavasis means. And within our sampradaya, all these six Goswamis, Rupa Sanatana, they are Vrajavasis. And that is also misconception in all these fellows who are third class, 10th class people who have just crowded Vrindavan now. And they are considered as Vrajavasis in modern sentimental ISKCON actually. They never aspire for it. Like in Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur in 1932, when he did the first time, when he did Vrajamandala Parikrama with his devotees, he said, I didn't find any pure devotee in whole of Vrajamandala. You can imagine 100 years back, almost 100 years back, 90 years back. That was the condition. Now, bhakti has improved or what? Consciousness has improved now. Now, after so long of preaching, chanting Hare Krishna, it should increase, no? Whether it is going up or it is going down, actually. We see that it is going down. Vrajavasis are infused with life, hence they preach their glorification of Krishna, being devoid of desire for fame. Prana ache tandra sehe tu prachara. Prabhupada would quote this, no? Shri Daita Dasa Kirtanete Asha Kara Uchaswari Harinama Rava Kirtana Prabhave Smarana Swabhave Sekale Bhajana Nirjana Samba. This servant of Sri Radha and Krishna always desires to glorify the Lord and enjoins all to loudly sing the names of Lord Hari. The transcendental power of Kirtana automatically awakens contemplation of the Lord. You see here Smarana Swabhave, Smarana. These Babaji's Apasampradayas. Only at the stage of Nirjana Bhajana is feasible. Okay, next song we will discuss tomorrow. Of course, we can't discuss that, it's too long. Prakrita Rasa Shatadushani. Prakrita Rasa Shatadushani. 100 refutations of mundane rasa, actually. It is, or you can call them as Sahajiyasam. So, 100 refutation of Sahajiyasam. Actually, we have to study that poem very nicely if we want to make systematic progress in bhakti, actually. Basically, it explains systematically 9 stages of bhakti and in what stage, what rules we have to follow. But it's little difficult to understand also. It's not so easy to eat. Because he writes in his own scholarly way. All this actually we just ran through actually, this Vaishnavakya song, but it has lot of deep meanings. He writes in his scholarly way, so that Prakrita Rasa Shatadushani also, very scholarly. Presentation of different stages of bhakti and what we have to follow, what we should avoid at all these stages actually. So, Niyamagraha. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he gave the meaning, he explained Niyamagra, saying that there are different stages of bhakti and in each stage there is do's and don'ts, which we should do and we should not do. So not following them is Niyamagraha. So he says, so like that. This is what Babaji Apasampradaya. Like that, there are so many apasampradayas. I want to discuss this in another session, this Chala Bhakti Dushana. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Any questions, comments? Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki jai.